So, we interrupt our regularly scheduled programming because #racism, #white supremacy, #ridiculousness. Like, I can't even like come on in like a cheery fashion because y'all, I'm in my feelings, like, for real, like, all jokes aside, I'm in my feelings. And, you know, I was like, I'm not gonna miss no days of Veda and all this, and I've been doing good. Like, I've been really doing good. I've been enjoying it. And I'm not fussing y'all out, but for real, I guess, you know, maybe I should use my platform to talk about things that are on my heart. I hate talking about this kind of stuff, especially here. And the reason is, I come to YouTube for an escape. Like, it's so much foolery in these streets that I come on YouTube because I want to be happy. I want to laugh. I want to, like, hang out with you guys, like, be girlfriends, you know, cousins, you know, as Evelyn from the internet says, internet cousins, you know. I want to just have fun. I don't, it's like, all this stuff is all the time. All the time. It's just straight foolery. Like, people have lost their ever-loving mind. So, I typically try not to come on camera aggravated or sad or anything like that because I use YouTube as an escape, like, away from regular reality. You know, I'm a realist. You know, I'm myself when I come on. And I really do use YouTube as an escape from the ridiculousness in this world. So, I don't know. You know, yesterday, you know, Saturday, actually, they were just rioting. You guys know about Charlottesville, Virginia. If you haven't heard, just Google it. It's just straight ridiculousness, like on level infinity. Like, it just baffles me how far we haven't come. Like, I am so thankful for the progress that has been made. It's been some progress. Like, it's been some progress. Like, I'm not gonna sit here and act like nothing has changed because things have changed, and but things haven't. And watching all the footage and all the everything with those people down there makes me feel like I'm watching a movie, like in history class, you know. Makes me feel like I've been lied to, like it was all a dream, you know, like what is really going on? I mean, it just baffles me too. My core every time this happens. And I mean every time, like every time senseless murders happen, every time I see stupid comments on people's feeds, you know, it's just a lot, you know. So Saturday, I'm glad I was with my best friend. We really just hung out. You guys saw my late night vlog where I was like too tired to vlog, you know. I just really used that time to just, you know, just, I don't know the word, relax, be with loved ones, you know, just not be concerned. I live in North Carolina, so, you know, all this ratchetness over here on the East Coast is like heightened even more because I'm over here. It's not like I'm in a different state far away, far, far away, where it's like, oh, them people over there, them crazies over there. No, they're like in my backyard. Acting a plum fool, like 2 hours from my bestie's mom's house, like, you know, family down in South Carolina, you know, it's just like so aggravating and so it makes me angered and it makes me outraged to see people acting like this now. I mean, I don't know. So, Saturday, you know, late, we just hung out. And just kind of decompress, I guess that's the word. And I just really didn't feel like vlogging. Like, I didn't feel like vlogging or doing anything. I just wanted to be with people that I loved. You know, I guess that was my coping mechanism. And yesterday, I really just was to myself. You know, it's just, it becomes overwhelming sometimes. And I don't know if everybody feels that way when this happens. I guess some people kind of feel like, well, it's the way it is. You know, I find myself calling my parents, you know, and like, when an anxious feeling happens, because they've lived through this and they've lived through worse than what we're seeing today, and they're still alive and prospering and happy, and they have joy, and they're my greatest examples of how to have joy and how to be thankful throughout all this mess, because it's just mess, y'all. It's just mess. So I went to church, you know, got the word. It makes me angry too, because a lot of these people spew Christian stuff or like Bible stuff, and it's the furthest thing from real Christianity and real, like, God for real, like, you know. So I guess it just takes me a little time, y'all, and I guess today for real, you know, I know I did a silly Veda when I was like, I gotta come and talk to y'all. No, I for real. Like, I guess that's my coping mechanism is, sometimes I just need to just decompress, I need to pray, I need to just relax, relate, release, you know, get my feelings together, get my thoughts together, so I'm not angry, like, in a destructive manner. You know, there's always going to be anger and frustration when you see this craziness happening, but I guess it helps me not act a plumb fool back, you know, like, let me get my girls and let's just roll out. You know, folks is getting killed out here over just, it's ridiculous. So I don't know. So this is my Veda for day 12, 13, 14, whichever. Because this is my real life, it's my real life experience, and I just want to say, you know, encourage you guys to love on your family, love on your friends, teach your kids, because, you know, we got, you know, my husband works in higher education, and we got students that are like my children to me, like, they call me mom, you know what I mean, and I'm always constantly like, y'all be safe, don't be smart mouth, don't be doing crazy stuff. You know, and I tell them I love them because I love them. I love them. Just hold on to your family. You know, be smart in whatever your involvement is going to be. If you're going to do the resistance, and there's millions of ways to resist and all these things that we see. Just be safe. Be smart. I'm not going to walk in fear. I'm not going to walk around with a bunch of fear, like I'm scared to go out my house or anything like that. Just be smart when you're out and about, and get involved in politics. We got to, you know, get involved, get the right people in government to help combat this foolery, and pray. So, not my typical Veda. Definitely not what I want to come on and talk about, but it's reality today. And if I come on here showing hair products and makeup and acting like none of this is happening, I'm not being real to myself. And that's not boundless living. In 2017, I said I'm going to live boundlessly. And that's part meaning that I have to be truthful and honest and forthcoming, even about how I feel about things, even if it doesn't feel so nice. You know, be safe out there, pray, you know, be kind to people, because everybody's not like those people. You know, try not to let hatred grow in your heart. Try not to let your anger turn into destruction in a multitude of ways, you know. Find the happy, you know, find the joy, be safe, tell your people you love them, take some time for yourself if you need it, and even tonight, me and my husband are just going to go out, you know, so I mean, my hair's, you know, trying to look like somebody, Me and hubby are gonna go out to dinner and hang out with some really amazing friends and just find the joy. Find the joy. So take care of yourselves too. Take care of yourselves through all this. So, not to be too rambly, love y'all so much, for real. And thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for all of you guys that watch my videos and comment in the comment section and participate and love me. And when I say I love you, I mean it. It's not just something I'm saying, you know. So, I love you guys, and I'll see you in the next video.